Good morning. I'm Carol Huchingson, the recovery coordinator. When I sat down to prepare for the recovery report today, I started thinking, you know, maybe there isn't that much to talk about, but there always is. There's always a lot going on in recovery. So I'll catch you up on things that have happened since I talked to you 2 weeks ago. On February 2nd, we held the After the Fire event, which was basically a resource fair about rebuilding. We had 35 participating agencies and over 185 members of the public that strolled through. We did a little exit interview with people as they left about what we might have done better, what we should have offered that we didn't. All the feedback was very good, and so we're really pleased that we hosted that event with the support of Cal OES and FEMA. Our task force meetings followed immediately after that event in the same venue, also on February 2nd. And in addition to the regular report outs at the task force meeting, we had a couple of special reports. Corinne Woodard of the USDA talked about the special programs they're offering and the resources that they can offer folks in the community, particularly those with agricultural interests and livestock, etc. Pete Johnson is a local representative from the St. Vincent de Paul agency, and he talked about these house-in-a-box units that are being brought in for people when they rebuild and are ready to move into their home. These house-in-a-box contain all of the contents that people need to put a house back together, almost all of the contents. And so he described those units and also talked about the need for storage space to keep them. They're going to bring them in. They're looking for about 10,000 square foot of donated space to store those. As I reported to you last time, we have concluded our efforts to place the mobile laundry unit. And as you know, I've been transparent through all of our recovery efforts, so I gave that same message at the task force meeting. We also put out a press release explaining where we're at with that. We've referred to it all along as a mobile laundry, but the truth is a portable laundry would probably be a better descriptor because it's not self-contained. And getting the infrastructure to it has been challenging from the beginning. County staff worked hard in the early months of the disaster to try and find a location for it. We were not able to do so for a long list of reasons. And so we reached a point where, as we are winding down our donations management efforts, we also wound down our efforts to secure a location for that. So we talked with your board about that two Tuesdays ago. We also discussed that at the task force meeting with the intent of opening it up to the community to see if members of the public might pose solutions. We've been very successful at task force meetings finding those kinds of solutions from time to time, and one great example was that I needed space to meet in the burn area. We put that need out there, and sure enough, somebody found me a location to meet with survivors there. But at this particular discussion, no solutions in the burn area were forthcoming. The community did not come up with a suggestion for where the mobile laundry could be placed and who might assume responsibility for it. And since then, there have been some negative social media postings. In fact, a letter was written that some of your board may have received. The letter was written by the man that developed the mobile laundry. And I want to backtrack and tell you that we made a point of thanking him for his intent in creating this unit. He was present at the task force meeting. We encouraged him to speak at the meeting. He opted not to do so. And since then, there have been postings in social media. A couple of things that were suggested that are in error. First of all, it was suggested that the county is mad at Cal Fire over the mobile laundry. At one point, Cal Fire said, yes, you could hook it up here, but we would still need liability. We would still need volunteers and supervision of such. We're good with that if someone else wants to handle those details. Cal Fire is our partner. There's no bad blood between us and Cal Fire, but there was no other entity forthcoming to solve those needs. Another piece of misinfo was that the board voted down the mobile laundry, and that isn't correct either. I take responsibility for that decision as your recovery coordinator because it's the time and the evolution of